Hello student, this is Dhanjit Deka and you are watching me on my YouTube channel Reaction Concept. Student, in this video we will discuss about different colligative properties of a solution. So before starting this video, I have a small suggestion for you that before starting this colligative property, you should go through the Van't-Hoff factor or abnormal molecular mass of a substance. Okay, so for that I have made a video in the previous class. So you should go through that class, then you can come to this colligative property. Because in colligative properties calculations, that Van't-Hoff factor you have to calculate. If you don't know how to calculate the Van't-Hoff factor for different solvent or different solute, it will create some difficulties for you. Okay. So my small suggestion is that you just go to that video, then come to this video. Okay. So let us start with our topic today's discussion. So we'll discuss about colligative property. So what are colligative properties? These are some properties of a solution that depends upon the nature of, it does not depend upon the nature of solvent or solute. It just depends upon the number of particles in the solution. So colligative properties of a solution depends on numbers of so colligative properties of a solution, it depends upon the number of particles of a solution. So we can define in such a way that colligative properties of a solution are those properties that depends upon the numbers of particles in the solution. So there are four colligative properties are there, and these are four colligative properties of a solution, and these are respectively lowering of vapor pressures, that is denoted by del P, elevation of boiling point of a solution del TP, and depression of freezing point of the solution, it is denoted by del TF, and the other one is osmotic pressure. So these are the four colligative properties we'll discuss. We'll go by one. First, consider the first one, what is lowering of vapor pressure. We can also say that it is relative lowering of. Let us first consider the first colligative property I have mentioned, that is relative lowering of vapor pressure. So before that, you should know the what is vapor pressure. So vapor pressure generally is the amount of pressure exerted by the vapor state on the surface of solution in the equilibrium state. Okay, this is called vapor pressure. So let us consider a solution. Suppose here you are considering a solution with a solvent, pure solvent here, A. Okay, you are considering a solvent A. And in this case also, in the pure solvent, there will be a vapor pressure of the solvent, that is PA naught. In this solvent, you are adding a solute B. This solute, it is provided that this is a non-volatile solid. This means this solid cannot undergo vaporization. So it cannot undergo in the vapor state. When we mix these two, we'll get a mixture of A and B. So this would be the solution. Okay. So in this case, it is the vapor. It is, in this case, in the solution, you see mole fraction of A, it is denoted by XA, and mole fraction of B, it is denoted by B. Okay. So in the pure state, you see, in case of pure state of solvent, the surface of the solvent is occupied by the solvent molecule only. But when we add this solute on the solvent, the surface of the liquid in the solution phase, it is occupied by some solute molecule B. So number of molecules in the surface of the solution of this solvent is decreases in the solution, because of decrease of solvent molecule on the surface, the possibility of going this solvent molecule to the vapor state is also decreases. Because of this, the vapor pressure exerted by this solvent A here will decrease. So there will be a decrease in the vapor pressure of the solution. Suppose the vapor pressure of the solution here denoted by PS. So in this case, this PS will be low. Why? Because the number of molecules that can undergo vapor state is minimized here because of presence of this non-volatile solute. So in this case, we can write PA naught. What is the? This is the vapor pressure of the pure solvent. This will be greater than the vapor pressure of the solution. Okay. The difference between these two, that is PA naught minus PS, this is called lowering of vapor pressure. And the ratio of this factor and PA naught, this ratio is called relative lowering of vapor pressure. Relative lowering of vapor pressure. Okay, so now we will calculate how this relative lowering of vapor pressure will depend upon the number of solute particle in the solution. Okay, how this colligative property will depend upon the number of particles of the solute in the solution. That thing we will discuss here. So in the earlier case, according to the Raoult's law, if we consider the Raoult's law, in case of solution here, you see, in case of solution, if we apply the Raoult's law, in case of component A, here component A is the solvent here, okay? So pressure exerted by the solvent PA in the solution, it will be the product of PA naught, that is the vapor pressure of that component in pure state, into mole fraction of that component in the solution, that is denoted by XA. Okay, so this would be the Raoult's law for component A, that is solvent. So it can be written as PA naught divided by PA divided by PA naught into XA. Also, you see here all the vapor pressure here exerted by the solvent part only, because the solute part in this case is a non-volatile solute. Okay, so because this is a non-volatile, it cannot undergo vapor state. So only molecule that can undergo vapor state is the solvent part. So here the vapor pressure of the solution should equal to the vapor pressure of the solvent component. So in this case, the solvent component, vapor pressure of the solvent component, we can write as vapor pressure of the solution divided by vapor pressure of the solvent in pure state equal to the mole fraction of the solvent. Now you see, here I am writing, if we both this term is subtracted from 1, what we will get? 1 minus PS PA naught 1 minus XA. So this will give you PA naught minus PS divided by PA naught 1 minus mole fraction of the solvent. It will give you mole fraction of the solute. So this is the, this term is called as relative lowering of vapor pressure. So relative lowering of vapor pressure is given by mole fraction of the solute. So what do we get from the above discussion? That is the relative vapor pressure, relative lowering of vapor pressure of a solution is equal to the mole fraction of the solute in the solution. Since this is a colligative property, thus it will depend upon the number of particles of the solute in the solution. This mole fraction is implying the number of particles in the solution. Okay, in the earlier, in this case, we are considering the solute as a non-electrolyte. Though I have mentioned, I have not mentioned these things, but in this case, we are considered that the solute is a non-electrolyte. But this solute can be electrolyte also, like sodium chloride. In this case, non-electrolyte means, suppose glucose, okay? Glucose is a non-electrolyte. It will not dissociate. So it will give you one molecule in the solution, one molecule of glucose. But when you dissolve electrolyte, this one, it will dissolve as a sodium ion and chloride ion. The number of particles in the solution here become 2 from 1. So for such type of solute, the number of particles is increases. But there are some other solute also where here dissociation occurs, but there are some also solute are there where association will happen. For such kind of solute, the increase in number of particles generally described by a factor that is called Van 't Hoff factor. This is Van 't Hoff factor. So this is a colligative, because this is a colligative property, we should also consider the number of particles of the solution. Okay, so this Van 't Hoff factor should also be introduced in this equation. So our equation will be, for relative lowering of vapor pressure, this should be like this, I into x of solute, that is mole fraction of solute. This Van 't Hoff factor, if association occurs, then this will be given as 1 plus n minus 1 into alpha. If dissociation occurs, if the solute is dissociated, okay, then the Van 't Hoff factor for the solute will be this one. If association occurs in the dissolution of the solute, then it will be given by 1 plus 1 by n minus 1 into alpha. If association occurs, these things is discussed in the earlier class, so I have suggested you to go to that class before starting this. Okay, so this is the relative lowering of vapor pressure of a solution. So guys, this is it from today's discussion. So if you have any doubt, you can ask me in the comment section below. In the next video, we will discuss about some problem based on these topics from whatever we have discussed in this class. Okay guys, so if you have any suggestion, any doubt, you can ask me in the comment section below. And if you are new to this channel, then subscribe our channel and don't forget to press the bell icon. So guys, thank you for today's class.